Tonight, News 5 is helping to protect your identity. Imagine waking up and finding your credit card and PIN number on a billboard along I-75. Well, for tens of thousands of us, it's even worse.
Now, News 5's Brian Hamrick has an eye-opening report tonight on just how quickly your personal information can be accessed. Brian?
Yeah, Sheree, for many people, those records are posted along the information highway. It's why one computer expert is saying we have a false sense of cybersecurity.
It's your most sensitive information.
Credit card numbers, social security numbers, anything.
And for an alarming number of people,
if I let it get to me, I wouldn't sleep at night.
It's information now indelibly tattooed on the internet. With a few clicks, we found the most guarded records on countless people across the nation.
There is a ton of information. I mean, hundreds of thousands of people. Their credit information's out there, and they have no clue.
Carl Hart is head of CyberCon Solutions, a local computer security company. He shows us how these data bank Dillingers apply Google to pick the locks of information vaults using certain codes as keys. Even though we're not showing the codes, they're no secret to the hackers who hide out in the nebulas of cyberspace, digging out data.
Phone number, social security number.
From information gold mines.
Mother's maiden name, driver's license.
Every nugget.
Account numbers, and their PayPal.
Another paycheck. We even found military documents titled Classified. One search brought almost 300 results, and just one of those documents was 88 pages of people and their bank records.
Whoever's got this information, my name is always like the third one down.
Including this tri-state man who we're not identifying, realizing his is among the most prominent names out there. He long ago canceled exposed credit cards.
What they do is they take my information knowing that they have my social security number, and they'll go to a credit card company and try to apply and say they're me.
Hackers even used a dating service under his name. They created a fake Facebook page, then lured unsuspecting women into a scam.
The character who says they're me says they're over in Africa on a mission, and they're over there for 6 weeks working with orphanages.
This man's minimized his own financial impact by creating a password with his credit card company. He's alerted the three major federal credit bureaus and regularly checks his credit report, all in an effort to deal with the latest shift in the mindset of cyber space invaders.
Hackers used to go after publicity. Hey, I defaced this website. It's all about money now.
Now, here are some tips to help protect yourself. Google your own name to see what comes up. Be stingy with information, even with facts like your mother's maiden name. Protection companies like LifeLock can help. So once your information is out there, it is very difficult to get off the internet. Sheree?